I am 22, and I have never killed a man. But I know a killer when I see one, muffled into a facade, scotched into bitterness. You see, I am not going to sit and pretend that a killer is a saint, as if our children are safe, as if poetry is not trying to punch windows between my teeth, begging me to speak into silence. You see, silence has never refused me. I have watched my heart turn into a fist, standing on the center of the breaking and the bending. I am only a boy who has mandinka on his tongue. I am only a boy who wants to feel the taste of his mother's laughter sinking in his stomach. I have come from too far and too close to not remember the hands that mold me into becoming sunlight. So understand me. Understand me when I say this. I burn best each time I convince myself that everyone living is broken inside, and everything broken inside will shimmer itself to death someday, and death in itself is the only guarantee that the tired will finally rest the eye. I tried to write this conversation into a love poem, but somehow I can't. Somehow I can't perfect writing love poems, but why waste my time anyway? Love does not inspire me anyway. I think this generation has a superficial kind of love. The only love poems I know how to write best are the ones I share with hate, with pain, with tears, with fear, with names, and how poetry makes me feel. These are the only consistent lovers I have. So this poem is a love poem. This poem likes to call names. This poem has buried so many of them. This poem has unloved some people. This poem is a gift, allowing some people take my silence as charity. This poem is trying to embrace newness, but also conflicting with the past. In this world of so many conversations, you see, I have learned to listen, to plant every seed in its ground, to push every music in its place, to unbutton this generation's ego and burn it to the ground to serve as fertilizer for true love. But wait, do not let the sad, loving, angry old poem teach you how to feel, okay? Like, can't you see that I am just so adorable? Like, I like sunflowers. I like spontaneous things. I like folding my body into a poem. I like darkness. It has never refused me. I like reality that comes with splits of pain. I like the water. It reminds me of my father's love. I like genuine people who smile as sweet as sugarcane. I like sugarcane. I like angry poems. I like the sad and the guilty. I think they have so much to say. I like to like the things we are asked not to like. I like to like myself. I like to sit with myself, to discuss about my healing with myself, to accuse myself of loving me too much. I like to be accused of bringing joy and sassiness to the dinner table. I like things that fire cannot burn. The seeds of the father brings forth the child. The seeds of the father brings forth the child. The seeds of my father brings forth this child. I have shown you all the height of my sweetness, yet you silence me into nothing, dissolve my optimism into nothing, call this skin a nothing. Now watch me decay into something. Tell me, does something sound beautiful? Tell me, does something sound like a thing of promise? You see, when you feel a poem, you know it is true. I want to live to witness another sunrise. But if I ever break out of this body again, I will die. So munch me like a rainbow in a cloud. I am only speaking to my life. There is no room for a child who lives in a wound anymore. We've built that house knowing we would not live there. But you do know this, don't you? I can't live in the same environment that got me sick in the first place. I can't harbor safety in a place that promises to end me. So tell everyone back home that I am not coming back home. I am building a home out of the fragments of newness I have found. Tell everyone, the land we sculpted with our hands never felt like home to me. Home to me is wherever I am free to become. Home to me is wherever this heart feels alive. Tell them all the colors and truth I have lived. I wear them honorably like a battle wound. Tell them my body is slowly repairing itself again. I am slowly moving towards living again. No longer do I hide my truth behind metaphors whilst my eyes listen with tears. Tell them to give nature's peace a chance, give peace a chance, give peace a chance. Tell them I have forgiven them with every fiber of my being. Tell them I wrote this poem as a souvenir. They will feel this poem. They will know it is true.